Zacchaeus. Maybe he told him about some of his friends. Didn't name them by name. But maybe that rich man that he spoke about in that parable, maybe it was one of somebody that Zacchaeus knew. Maybe Lazarus that died and the angel ushered his body away to glory land. Maybe it was somebody that Zacchaeus knew. And Zacchaeus was getting a word from the Lord. And after Zacchaeus heard the gospel, Zacchaeus at the 8th verse stood and said unto the Lord, Lord, the half of my goods I will give to the poor. And if I take anything from any man by false accusation, I will restore it fourfold. What's that kid was saying when he went home with Jesus, when he went up the sycamore tree and took Jesus home? He was saying, I believe that you are the Son of God. And after Jesus got through talking to him, Zacchaeus began to say, and so many words, all the wrong that I've done, what have I done wrong? I'm willing to make it right. Zacchaeus was saying, I want to be a new creature. Zacchaeus was saying, Jesus, I want to be just like you. Zacchaeus was saying, Jesus, I want to be a holy man of God. Zacchaeus was saying, Jesus, wash me free from my sins. That's basically what he was saying. He confessed with his mouth. He believed with his heart. Amen. That Jesus is the Son of God. Yeah, Jesus hadn't died yet, but he was yet walking the earth. He believed on the only begotten Son of God. And when Zacchaeus got talking, got through it on enough to that he done messed up, got through on enough that he needed a change to come. Somebody, you need to own up that you need a change to come. Somebody need to own up that you've been messing up down through the years. If you don't ever own up that you need help, you won't get no help. If you don't ever own up that I've been wrong in my life, God, you never going to get right. I've been wrong. Too many people don't want to own up that they're unsaved. Too many people don't want to own up that they're on the way to hell. Amen. But you need to own up to it that you are undone without Jesus. You need to own up to the fact that you're lost without Jesus. You need to own up to the fact you get the time around the big title of a rich man. Oh, ain't none of y'all rich again.
Thank you.
Amen. You need to own it to the fact that you need Jesus as your Savior. I'm saved, but I still need Jesus. Somebody don't like that song, I need Jesus in my whole life. I need him every day. Sometimes I need him to do a new thing in my life. Sometimes I need some help get straight. Sometimes I mess up, I need help to get that right. Come on, say glory, somebody. But as sure as the people are, you and I get real with God, get real with Jesus. Amen. Jesus will say this to you. Jesus said unto Zacchaeus, in the hearing of anybody else that was around, Jesus said, this day is salvation come to this house. For as much as he also is a son of Abraham, for the son the Son of Man is come seeking to save that which was lost. I want you to know today that Jesus, he's seeking to save that which is lost. Anybody that have not been born again, you're lost. You might be walking around. You may be in this building on 1221 East 19th Street. You may be walking down 19th Street at this moment. They tell me sometimes they hear us over in the other block. Well, if you're listening to me right now, you may be home on 20th Street. You're lost unless you know Jesus Christ. I didn't say you have to be a member of this assembly, but you need to be a member of the body of Christ. You need to be washed in the blood of the Lamb. saved that want to get saved for the most part. For the most part, you have opportunity to get saved. And then you believe on the Son of God. You confess him that he lived, died, and rose again. You confess your sins to him and ask him to come into your life. And you're willing to make a complete change. Turn around from the old man and begin to walk according to the word of the Lord. Amen. The word of God said, you confess with your mouth or leave with your heart, so then you shall be saved. Amen. Amen. So if you really mean that, amen, Jesus was saved. Some of y'all looking at getting saved like it's a hard process. It's not a hard process. Some of y'all think getting saved means you gotta slob. You gotta run down your nose. Some of y'all think getting saved means you gotta pray for hours and hours. No, all that means if you got a well-made up mind, amen, then you come to him and ask him to come into your life and ask him to forgive you for your sin, and you mean it from your heart. You ask him, the only begotten Son of God, to come into your life and forgive you for your sin, and tell him you want to live for him. Amen. He'll save you. Come on, say glory, somebody. It won't take him no long time. He can save you in a matter of seconds. Come on, say glory, somebody. And after that kid did all this, amen, it was just a few words. Jesus said, today is salvation come to this house. And you are a son of Abraham, meaning you are a son of faith. I am a child of faith. I walk by faith. I'm going to go to heaven by faith. I haven't seen it yet, but the word of the Lord tells me that there is a place and glory for the people of God. It tells me that anybody that believes not on the name of the only begotten Son of God, there's another place called hell. We cast into the lake of fire one day. Anybody want to be saved today? In just a moment. It don't take a moment. God will save you today. Somebody say anybody coming? You don't know that. So throw that thought away. Heaven already told me that. It ain't happening. God, I know God's working on people. Anybody wants to come today? Everybody on your feet.
Thank you, Jesus.
And give your life to Christ.
Thank you, God.
Praise you.
I ask that you come. Anybody. He'll save you. Thank you. Another song said he wants to save you. Anybody.
Thank you, Jesus.